I grew up with a family with normal problems. I didn't know from right or wrong. I was just a kid, 5 years old. I have parents who would argue, sometimes even constantly. I've experienced and noticed later that my parents weren't happy with each other. And then one day, things got out of control. I wasn't sure what the bottle of what I once thought was apple juice was. Why my mother was throwing my favorite glass cups at my dad. I didn't know why those men came with those cars with flashing lights that came in the middle of the night. I saw my father there outside, sitting on the porch with his hands cuffed behind him. It was cold outside. I was just a kid, 5 years old. When I was 10, they had gone back together for the sake of their kids. My family and I were moved to Fresno. I didn't really know why they had told me that they were going to start business there. We moved. I started liking a girl from my new school, seeing that things were settling. I liked it there. The phone rings. I was excited. Happy and ready to talk to my dad and tell him to come to our new home. He still worked at his old job in Santa Rosa. He told us that he was staying there for a while and was bringing back some stuff from the old house to finish the move. But something was wrong. My mother's tone changed and she started crying. What was wrong? My sister was only 7 at the time. She didn't know what was going on. She was too young to understand. My mother yelling over the phone, "Be cheating on me." I didn't really know how to react or what that meant. I had gotten mad and grew impatient. I took the phone from her. I screamed at it. "Why? This is all your fault." I gave him no chance to explain. I was hurt. I didn't know what to do. Now that I look back, that was when I lost my old self, a happy kid who was proud of his friends, his family, what had really meant a lot to me. I was traumatized. I didn't know how to overcome it. We moved back to Santa Rosa. My parents are divorced. I live with my mother and I was in middle school. I thought of wearing Dickies and Ben Davis was cool. I just wanted to fit in. I had started hanging out with the wrong people, doing drugs. I didn't realize that I was losing myself. In reality, I didn't want to be home because of all the trauma. I tried impressing the wrong people for the benefit of acknowledgement. I really felt alone and empty. Those punk kids I thought were cool, but just like me, had a messed up family and needed unity of some sort. To not have the feeling of being alone, that's why I started doing drugs and doing unforgettable things. Because of peer pressure, I wanted to be acknowledged for who I thought I was. I soon came to a point to where I just didn't care anymore. I thought of suicide, but what for? Because of the people I cared about, for the ones I loved. We're too busy doing their own thing, no one cares. They only focus on what or who interests them. I was scared. What was to come next? My mother wasn't a regular drinker, but it had gotten worse. It seemed to be an excuse for her to get over the pain she was dealing with. I was stupid and ignorant. I pushed all her buttons to get her mad. I haven't realized that I was doing it on purpose either, but not knowing what the outcome of that made my future difficult to cope with. Years passed now, and I'm a senior in high school. But what really happened in those 5 years before? Well, let's begin with my father. He took care of some kids for a friend. She is now my stepmother. It's funny how they met. Things changed after that. Ruben, Leo, Liana, Alonso, and Alicia are now part of my life, as well as my sisters. My dad seemed happy when he was with her, and soon began dating. I've only gone to visit as court's order for visitation. I was still a mischief teen during that time. I once raised my fist at my dad. I don't quite remember how we got in that particular situation. I would regularly get suspended and get Friday school. I was pushing everything away. I look back and wonder if I didn't do what I did. Would I have been more prepared for college? And my relationship now, would it have changed how they view me? I was a lovable kid. Everyone who knew me would say hi, but I can't remember what I did for them to be my friends. My memory has gone blank. It just disappeared. My sophomore year, I was growing out of the habit. I attended school regularly, and I played football. Ever since that day my mom and dad split up, I lost something valuable. What a healthy family relationship needs, or anyone. Trust. Why and when, these two questions I'm still trying to figure out. After football season was over, I had new friends in Pioneer High. I just didn't know how to express myself with them. I was new to this. What I've done before was push my friends away. Now it's different. I later realized that the only encouragement I received from my mom and my dad and my stepmom one who has given me the most was my mother, because I will always be a little baby boy and will love me no matter what. I found this out after she had been deported to Mexico a while back. And when I was in the juvenile delinquency center, she came to visit me, and I was an hour and a half away. No, it wasn't like traveling from here to Mexico, which I have already done, to go visit her last summer. I stood there asking the officer if I could go back to my unit. I cried. It hurt me so much that the day she lied and filed a report on my stepmom for vandalism, I lost it. She had no proof, and her reason was just unexplainable. And for the length of time I've been there, no one knew I was there, just my mom and dad. Of course, I soon came to forgive her, but how she can forgive me when I put her through hell? Later, dealing with another problem, my stepmom is now in the same shoes my mother was in, being ridiculed by my own family, my own uncles and aunts, who had raised me when I was a boy. They lost my respect, my trust, and just because they think we're family doesn't mean we would automatically forgive them. Trust was to be earned, not just because we're blood related. It took me years to forgive my mother. Now I'm a senior, 18 years old, and I have been living with my dad. I don't know what I could have do without him. I believe in change. Without change, my mother, my father, my stepmom, my brothers, my sisters, and myself wouldn't be who we are today. I can find out who we really are in the long run.